Live from the Government Social Media Conference in Nashville, Tennessee, this is episode 18 of EMS Talk.
Are you a first responder, EMT, paramedic, or involved with emergency management? Then this is the podcast for you.
Grab yourself a cup of coffee. And remember, if it's not giving you PVCs, it's probably not strong enough.
Broadcasting from the White Oak EMS studio in Pennsylvania, welcome to EMS Talk. Here's your host, EMS Chief Paul Falavolito.
And what's up, everyone, and welcome back to EMS Talk. This is episode 18 and a very special episode for you this evening because it applies to EMS. It applies to emergency management. It applies to everything. And for this episode, we are going to go all the way to Nashville, Tennessee. I have live on the air right now from the Keystone Emergency Management Agency, Amy Amer. Hello.
Hey, how are you?
I'm doing fantastic. So rumor has it that you have been at the government social media conference all week long in Nashville.
I have been. It's been a great experience. 920 people here from all across the United States.
Wow, that's amazing. So they don't have any international folks?
Maybe some from Canada. They have a map, and I didn't take a good look at the map before I came up. So it's great. The amount of people, the amount of networking, I can't even begin.
So tell me all about government social media. Is this the first time you've ever been to it?
No, this is the second time I've been to it. This is actually their fifth conference. They move it around every year. It was in Reno, Texas, Denver, and then here. I think they did 2 years in Reno. So the Government Social Media Conference is part of the Government Social Media Organization that's based out of Reno, Nevada. And they call themselves Gizmo, G-S-M-C-O, I believe is what they're...
Gizmo.
Yeah. So, Gizmo.
Oh.
So it's just been a great experience. They have vendors here from vendors, but really it's representatives from Facebook, Twitter, Snapchat, Hootsuite, Nextdoor. All of the major platforms are all here, and they're willing to sit down and talk to you.
So give me an example of some of the classes that you've attended.
So what have I attended this week? One of the first classes I attended was job recruiting on social media, different ways to record or to recruit on social media. Now, it was more law enforcement centric, but anybody can do it. Emergency management, EMS, just how you can do it for free with your phone, you know, and edit it with your phone. So
that's pretty cool.
Yeah. Different. They gave us different tips along the way. That one specifically, I've noticed a theme now in the conference that video is a huge, huge part of the conference. Because if you think about it, where do you look at social media? On your phone.
Right.
So 90% of social media is viewed on your mobile device. So you need to think about when you're making videos or making messages that it needs to apply to the device in your hand.
So you're talking about like if an EMS company has a presence on social media or even an emergency management agency has a presence on social media. You're saying that any message they want to deliver, the more video that they can put out on their platform, the more likelihood it's going to do better on social media.
Yeah. And it can't be like a minute long video because really you have 8 seconds to grab somebody's attention. 8 seconds. So they're even saying like graphics that move around a little bit, you know, with just a couple of words on it and pushes them to someplace else, whether it's an expanded article or pushes them back to your website.
That's fascinating. See, I get into all the analytics of Twitter and social media. Like Twitter's my big one. Like that's probably my favorite one out of all of them. So now, does it seem like are they pushing one platform more than another at this conference, or because they're all there, they have to give them equal billing?
Everybody has equal billing, but if you think of some things like, you know, Twitter is a faster moving service. you know, you have what, 200 plus characters to get through, you get your message out there. Facebook, you want to come to and they, you have a story to tell. It's just, everybody has a different platform. You know, you have 10 seconds of video on Snapchat. Nextdoor is more community oriented. So it's all different.
Yeah. Now I assume, are there classes geared on social media strategy?
Absolutely.
So
strategy.
So I'm sorry, I don't want to cut you off, but maybe you and I can have this discussion, because I can remember this was one of the things I went round and round with a lot of people with years ago in my organization, when we talk about, you know, how to deliver White Oak EMS on social media, right? And so we have a Facebook page, and we have a Twitter page, and we have a website. My big strategy, and again, please feel free to tell me if I'm 100% wrong. You're not going to, like, crush my soul, okay? Because I need to know the truth. My belief was always that if I'm going to be on Twitter, and if I'm going to be on Facebook, and if we're going to have a website, when I want to push a message out, it needs to be slightly different on all the different platforms, instead of saying, hey, it's going to snow tomorrow, and that message goes out on Twitter, and the same message goes out on Facebook, and then I have the same message posted on Facebook. Because my theory is, it's hard to get followers, right? I mean, Facebook, it's easy, right? You just click people and you friend request them, right? But Twitter, standalone Twitter, it's very difficult to get followers. So why would someone, if you're friends with them on Facebook and they can see the message that it's going to snow, why would they then want to follow you on Twitter to see the same message that it's going to snow? You know what I'm saying?
I understand. But what the biggest thing that you have to keep in mind is that all of those platforms are all different demographics for each of the platforms. You know, if you walked into a room of teenagers right now, ask them how many have Facebook, maybe a handful of hands, and they'll say, well, I only have it because my mom has it. You know, Snapchat and Instagram, those are your demographics for the younger population. I think Facebook is like 35, 40 and up. You know, Twitter, same thing. So I think it depends on the demographics that you want to reach.
So back to the original point, if you were going to push a message out, and what do you use on for your job?
I use Facebook and Twitter with a little bit of Instagram thrown in.
Okay, so like when you put out a message, let's say it's your, I don't know, give me an example, like a community fair.
So we would post a picture, come see Amy at the community fair, give the location, hey, we'll be here until 4, stop by and see, you know, our new bags or something like that, or see Amy and Justin, whoever I'm working the event with a picture of our table, maybe our location, you know, where we are or what swag we're giving away.
But you would change that message up across the platforms slightly or like drastically?
Slightly, depending on, you know, character length and stuff like that. And actually that message I wouldn't push onto Insta. That would only be a Facebook and Twitter message.
Gotcha. So what other fun classes did you do or are you going to do?
Well, tomorrow is the last day of the conference. One of the our opening session actually was a combination from Twitter and Hootsuite. And I really got a lot out of that, especially all of the different analytic tools and different things that Twitter now has to offer. And the dashboard that they have to offer. I'm a huge Hootsuite fan. For those of you that don't know what Hootsuite is, it is a tool that you can use to manage all of your social media accounts in one dashboard. You can manage, they have a free version. You can manage three different profiles in there. And by no means am I trying to sell Hootsuite on this podcast. I think it's a wonderful tool, though, if you have multiple platforms that you're trying to get the same message out on.
Well, I know why you're pushing Hootsuite, and I think you should tell everyone what Hootsuite gave you.
Oh, Hootsuite gave me a pair of socks.
Do they say Hootsuite on them?
They do. and an owl, because they do, their bit links are alleys, or OWL is their link. So I'm showing Paul here my owl.
Oh, I see it. That's cute. Yeah, that's kind of neat. I'm going to have to try Hootsuite, because I've always used TweetDeck.
Yeah, but see, but you're just you primarily like Twitter.
Yeah.
So, but you can do everything in
so you're saying you can link Facebook and Twitter.
And Insta.
And Instagram. Here's another question for you. Is there a LinkedIn presence at this conference?
No. Or Google is not here either.
Wow. I'm kind of shocked by that.
Mm-hmm. I really thought Google would be here.
Huh. So you're walking around at this conference and you're saying literally there's like a Facebook booth and a Twitter booth and you can walk up to these people and like, what are they there to like, what's their, like, what are they doing at the booth for the attendees?
So the Facebook booth there, they have a government team specifically to handle the government sector. Last year, Eva, who runs the government sector from Facebook, she was a team of one. She handled all of our requests for the entire United States. She now has a team of, it's her and like four people or three people, and they divided up the United States. We can go up to them and be like, hey, I need my page verified, or and my Instagram, because Facebook and Instagram, you know, are both the same company now. So they can verify pages. Or they offer this new program about, you know, the I'm Safe program or the disaster safety check-in. So you can go in and make sure that as a public safety agency that you have access to look at that information.
You know, that's a good point. And I'll tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to take a quick commercial break. And when we come back, I want to talk more with you about that disaster stuff that's on Facebook.
Okay.
Okay, so we'll be right back.
EMS Talk. It's the best EMS-related podcast I've found online.
It's usually playing on someone's phone during the morning truck check. It's great stuff.
It's very informative. I love their perspective on EMS topics.
We listen to it every day at the station.
It's always on.
EMS Talk is the only EMS podcast I listen to.
You're listening to EMS Talk, the podcast for EMTs, paramedics, emergency management, and other first responders. Brought to you by White Oak EMS. Be sure and follow White Oak EMS on Facebook and Twitter.
More EMS Talk right now. Okay, we're back, and I'm talking live with Amy Amer. She's in Nashville, Tennessee right now, currently attending the Government Social Media Conference. Amy, are you still with me?
I'm still with you.
Okay, cool. So before we went to break, you had mentioned the, what did you call it, the disaster check-in feature on Facebook?
And I
think we've all seen it, right? Like when there's like a big mudslide, or the, you know, the one that comes to mind for me, or the California wildfires that have been popping up in the last few years. And I'll always log on and it'll say, you know, Jane Doe marked herself safe in the, you know, San Bernardino wildfire. That's what we're talking about, right?
Right.
Okay. Right. So what is the, do you know, like, what's the parameters? And I guess this is important for emergency management as well as the listeners. What are the parameters to get that activated? Can an individual activate that, or does the government activate that?
So Facebook actually activates it, I believe. Now, I'm not quite sure how it all works, because they only have it rolled out to a couple of cities, like large cities. And I say a couple, but I think 300 is what they have it rolled out to. Don't quote me on that number. But what the safety check feature is it's so people can check in and say that, mark themselves as safe. Because if you go back to Hurricane Sandy, what was that? Superstorm Sandy. You know, the biggest words on Facebook that week were, I'm safe, we're safe. So that's when Facebook started to implement this process so people can mark themselves as safe. What they're looking at doing right now is to ensure that the data is accurate. That was the one thing that we asked to make sure that they're, I don't want to say fake news, but to make sure that the information that we as emergency management is getting back. Did I answer your question or did I talk around it?
Yeah, no. I think that's good. I think that's good because that's something that I've, you know, from an emergency management point of view, I've always wondered how that, you know, how that works or like what's the threshold or the criteria, you know, for it. You know, does it have to be like, I don't know, like, I don't know what the parameters are. Like here in Western PA, we've had a lot of flooding. And I know that in 2018, it was a historic year for Allegheny County. They declared more state of emergencies than ever before in the history of the county. And so, but like, I never saw anything like that pop up for us for any of the flooding or anything like that. So that's why I was just always curious, like, what's the threshold or the parameter for that to like just suddenly appear on someone's Facebook?
And I'll be honest with you, Paul, that I have every intention of going to Facebook tomorrow to talk to them about this all day. They were our keynote speaker this morning. And since she got off the stage at 9:15, they've had a line of 50 to 75 people waiting to talk to the three people at the booth all day. So I've been trying all day to get back there because I have a list of questions for them.
Well, maybe they're giving away Facebook socks.
No, they're giving away Hershey Kisses with the thumbs up and the heart.
What?
On them.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
Well, that's disappointing. That's disappointing. You know, I think we're on to something here with this topic. And I don't like mean to volunteer you for it because, you know, I am part of your conference planning committee for the next KEMA conference. It is your conference committee. I mean, you're the one that's the chairman of the conference committee. Okay. But my problem every time I go to an EMS conference or every time I go to an emergency management conference or any kind of little, you know, one day seminar or event and they say there's going to be a social media class, they're all the same.
Oh my gosh. Not here. Not at all.
No. I get that. But that's what I'm saying is I think what we're talking about right now, this feature on Facebook, would be so perfect for October for the KEMA conference.
Absolutely. So that's part of my hope here is that I have our regional air reps information. So I'm actually hoping that once I get my county up and running, I can turn around and present this as part of the conference. With the KEMA conference, you know, I am planning on having like a PIO section because in Pennsylvania, we don't have a PIO working committee. And so how do you do things the public information wise in Western versus how I do it on the East Coast of Pennsylvania?
I just divert back to you because I know you're doing it the right way in the East. It's the truth. I'm serious. It's the absolute truth. We don't have I know that our county, like, Allegheny County Emergency Services, I know they have like PIO people, but you know, here in my municipality, I mean, we don't have a PIO, you know, I mean, that's why I have to go take all the PIO classes. Not that I'm trying to become a PIO, but you know, the educational component of that's beneficial for me to do my job as a, you know, deputy emergency management coordinator. But I'm just saying that that's one of my big pet peeves is every time there's a conference, you know, the social media classes are all the same. They're so dry. It's, oh, are you on Facebook? Are you on Twitter? Here's how to create an account. And it's like,
We got to be beyond that now.
Yeah, you have to.
You need to pick up. I mean, I have a notebook here. And in 3 days, I've taken like 25 pages of notes. This is my full-time gig. Like I do social media all the time, full-time. And I have 25 pages of notes.
Yeah, well. And while I have you here for the last couple minutes, where can the listeners of this podcast follow your social media for your job?
For my job, I have a couple of different social media accounts that you can follow. You can find me on Facebook. I'm at Chester County Department of Emergency Services. On Instagram, I am Chesco DES. Twitter is CCDES. That's my work stuff. If you ever want to reach out to me personally, you know, you can find me through those channels and talk to me that way. And I'm glad to talk to anybody about social media or what you want to do.
Yeah, I mean, again, it's a no-brainer here in 2019. You know, if you're in EMS, if you're running an EMS agency, if you're in emergency management, you know, you got to have a presence on social media. You've got to be able to push out info to the public, because I know, and again, I don't know if I've, you know, told you this story, but I came to the KEMA conference in October, and that was my first interaction with KEMA. And, you know, I came back from that supercharged, and I really looked at how does my community push messages out to our population. And, you know, there's a page on Facebook called What's Happening in White Oak, and it has something like 9,000 members to it. And it seemed like that's where all the news for White Oak was happening. I know our police use Nixel. Is Nixel at the conference?
Nixel is at the conference. They're part of a larger company called Everbridge.
Oh, okay.
Everbridge provides notification systems.
Yeah. And so getting back to my point, though, it's just the one thing that was missing was, you know, emergency management for White Oak didn't have a presence. And so I came back from your conference, started a Twitter, started a Facebook page. And, you know, and so now we're able to, you know, push messages out to the public officially and then have those retweeted or, I'm sorry, reposted in that, you know, What's Happening in White Oak Facebook page. And it just, you know, to me, it's really making the delivery of official information very beneficial to the public.
So it's funny that you mentioned that, because I'll tell you what Facebook just did. So when you put that information on What's Happening White Oak page, you do it as yourself, as Paul, right?
No, I do it as White Oak Borough Office of Emergency Management.
That's awesome that you just mentioned that, because they actually just completely turned that on. So every pages can post in groups. So that's amazing, because before I would have to post as Amy in our group, in different groups in my county. So the fact that that's, I mean, they literally just turned that on in the past couple of months.
So you're saying that from like the OEM page that I was just mentioning, I can create a post and then
on
what's happening?
White
Oak. Yeah. So from the Office of Emergency Management page, you're saying I can hit like a drop down and put post in a group?
Yep.
And pick that group.
Yep.
Oh, wow. That's cool.
Yeah, we'll have to screen share, and I can show you how to do it.
Yeah, yeah, we're definitely gonna have to get on board with that, because that's gonna be a huge, huge thing. So, is there anything else I'm leaving out, or anything else you want to talk about from the government social media conference?
The only other thing that I'd like to add on here, with all the data problems and hacking and everything, the biggest thing that they were stressing to us today was making sure that you had the two-factor authentication turned on your Facebook account, you know, especially if you share pages or whatever, if you share a page with one of your deputies or, you know, at White Oak, everybody should have two-factor authentication turned on just to protect yourselves and protect your account. Security is big. Make sure you change your password all the time.
Guess what I'm going to be turning on as soon as I hit end. Yeah, because I don't think I have that turned on.
Yeah, that's one of the big things that they're posting, you know.
Okay, very cool.
But, you know, I would like to talk about this kind of topic again. So think of all the information. I have so much in my head.
Yeah, I definitely will. Did they mention where next year's government social media conference is going to be?
No, but they've been dropping hints all week. So
what are the hints?
Right now, well, sea level is the biggest hint.
Sea level?
Yep.
New Orleans or Miami?
That's what's going right now on Twitter. So we have a poll going on Twitter. So can you imagine though, like on Twitter, our hashtag, 920 of us tweeting to it constantly.
Yeah. So. Wow. I wonder what the analytic report looks like from that conference.
We are the number one trending topic right now in Nashville.
Wow. That's awesome.
Yeah.
Well, good for you. You know, it's good to accomplish things in life. So add that to your resume that you were part of the number one trending Twitter topic in Nashville.
Wait, in Nashville, but also at the conference, too, at the KEMA conference, because you really pushed that with your tweeting.
Yeah, well, There you go.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, listen, I appreciate you taking exactly 25 minutes out of your time while you're there in Nashville.
Anytime.
Have a safe trip back to Westchester.
I will.
And to everyone out there listening, thank you again so much for all of your support, and we'll see you next time.
That's a wrap for this edition of EMS Talk. And remember, if you don't drive safely, we get to see you naked. Until next time, stay safe out there.